Hello guys, today I am discussing about vaccine development in global pandemic. First, it is very important to know what is vaccine. A vaccine is a biological preparation used to stimulate the production of antibodies and provide immunity against one or several diseases. Contains a agent which resembles a disease-causing microorganisms and is often made from weakened or killed form of the microbe, its toxin or one of its surface protein. Now let's come, what is global pandemic? According to World Health Organization, that is WHO source, a pandemic is defined as the worldwide spread of a new disease, such as coronavirus disease 2019, that terms as COVID-19, which is caused by severe acute respiratory syndrome, coronavirus 2. SARS-2 COVID-2. On March 11, 2020, WHO declared COVID-19 as global pandemic. Scientists and researchers worldwide raced to develop a vaccine in the fight against global pandemic COVID-19, where main focus is to the so-called spike protein, which is present in the COVID virus. The spike protein interacts with ACE2 protein on human cells, facilitating infection of the cells, encouraging the virus to replicate and cause disease. Several vaccines in development are aimed at exposing the body to spike protein and having the immune system recognize it as an antigen or foreign. The immune system then develops a response with specialized white blood cells that are aimed at either destroying the virus or producing antibody that will block infection by the virus when exposed to the real pathogens. Now let's come to understand how vaccine do work against COVID-19. We should know how it develops immunity against new pathogens and how body adaptive immune system can learn to recognize new invading pathogens. Actually, vaccine work by training the immune system to recognize and combat pathogens, and to do this, some portion of pathogens or pathogen itself in form vaccine are injected into the body to trigger immune response and develop body immunity that prevent the future infection by same pathogen without getting sick. Now let's come in this diagram. This is a coronavirus. Coronavirus, the structure of the coronavirus. This is the spike protein. This is the M protein, I think membrane protein, and is a genomic material, that is single stranded positive RNA. The virus uses its surface spike protein to lock onto ACE2 receptor on the surface of the human cells. First, the virus enters the body by nasal airway or bronchial airway, and after binding with ACE2 receptor on host cell, they can enter the cell. After entering the cell, virus fuses with vesicles and its RNA is released. And then viral RNA translated into protein by host machinery in endoplasmic reticulum. And after that, the virus assembly occurs in Golgi complex. And last, virus released from the cell. When the virus released from the cell, some specialized antigen presenting cell, APC, engulf the virus and display portion of it to activate T helper cell. Now let's come, what is the function of the T helper cell? T helper cells secrete some cytokines which can activate and proliferate B cells and cytotoxic T cells. B cells is activated and make its B cell clone, and after that it can make two cells, plasma cells and memory cells. B cell prevent virus from binding or tag it for destruction by performing the antibody. Cytotoxic T cells destroy the infected cell by secreting perforin enzyme from it. And cytotoxic T cells can produce the memory T cells. And this long-lived memory B and T cell that recognize the virus can patrol the body for months or years, providing immunity. And vaccine harness this mechanism. Some factors should be considered in vaccine development when a perfect vaccine is desirable. Safety. Safety is exactly what it sounds like. Is a vaccine safe to give to people? Some minor side effects like a mild fever or injection site pain can be acceptable, but you don't want to inoculate people with something that makes them sick. Second, efficacy. Efficacy measures how well the vaccine protects you from getting sick. Although you would ideally want a vaccine to have 100% efficacy, many don't. For example, this year flu vaccine is around 45% effective. Beyond safety and efficacy, there are a couple of factors which can affect the vaccine development. That is duration of immunity. Ideally, the vaccine will give you long-lasting protection, but we might end up with one that only stops you from getting sick for a couple months, like the seasonal flu vaccine, which protects you from about 6 months. If that happens, the short-term vaccine might be used while we work on a more durable one. Then, doses. It can be single or multiple. A vaccine you will only get once is easier and quicker to deliver, but we may need a multi-dose vaccine to get enough efficacy. And last one is storage. Many common vaccines are kept at 4 degree centigrade temperature. That's around the temperature of your average refrigerator. So storage and transportation is easy, but RNA vaccine need to be stored at much colder temperature, as low as minus 80 degree Celsius, which will make reaching certain parts of the world more difficult. Now let's come development of new vaccine. Vaccine development is a long complex process, often lasting 10 to 15 years and involving a combination of public and private involvement. There are 5 stages of development cycle of a vaccine: are exploratory stage, preclinical stage, clinical development, regulatory review and approval, manufacturing and quality control. Now let's come into the 5 stages of vaccine development. First one is exploratory phases. This stage involves basic laboratory research to identify natural or synthetic antigen. This antigen could include virus-like particles, weakened virus or bacteria, weakened bacterial toxin or other substance derived from pathogens. This stage often lasts for 2 to 4 years. Second one is preclinical phases. In this phase, vaccine is given to animals such as mice or monkey to see if it produces an immune response. It often lasts 1 to 2 years. Third one is clinical development phases. This stage consists of 3 phases, which are discussed in our next slide. In these phases, the vaccine is given to human body for safety and doses and to confirm its effectiveness. It often lasts up to 5 years. Fourth one is regulatory review and approval. This stage is very important for vaccine development. In this stage, regulators of each country review the trial results and decide whether to approve the vaccine or not. It often lasts for 1 year. And last one is manufacturing and quality control. In this stage, good manufacturing practice, that is GMP, is implemented to ensure that products are safe for use in humans and also ensure that the identity, strength, quality and purity of product consistently meet regulatory specification and also quality control measures. Now let's come into clinical development phases. This phase focuses on safety, and this phase consists of three phases. Phase 1. These stages include 20 to 100 healthy volunteers, and this stage studies the safety of the vaccine. That means in this stage, the scientists begin to learn how the size of the dose may be related to side effect. If possible, at the early stage, scientists also try to learn how effective the vaccine may be. If no serious side effects are found in phase 1, then comes into a phase 2. This phase often lasts several months. Now let's come into phase 2. These stages include 100 to 300 healthy volunteers. This phase studies the efficacy of the vaccine. That means this stage can provide some additional information on common short-term side effects and how the size of the dose relate to immune response. These stages often last up to 2 years. And last one is phase 3. These stages include 1,000 to 3,000 healthy volunteers. And this stage studies the both safety and efficacy of the vaccine. These stages last up to 1 to 4 years. In this stage, 100 or 1,000 of volunteers participate, and vaccinated people are compared with the people who have received a Plavix or another vaccine. So researchers can learn more about the test vaccine safety and effectiveness and identify the common side effect. Now let's come vaccine development in normal circumstances. I have already discussed about 5 stages of vaccine development in my previous slide. Now let's come that this diagram. This diagram shows a typical vaccine timeline, which will take 10 to 15 years. 2020, the vaccine development has started, and it will end 2036. Now let's come in vaccine development in pandemic situation. This main goal is 12 to 18 months. Now let's come this diagram. This diagram shows some overlapped phases and shortened development time. Then let's go first, skip research. I have already discussed about that stages, which will involve basic lab research. But in pandemic situation, scientists has to skip some research for accelerating vaccine development. Then comes into combined phases. Another way to accelerate vaccine development is to combine phases. Some coronavirus vaccine are now in phase 1 and 2 trials. For example, in which they are tested for the first time on 100 of pupils. In a phase 2 part of the clinical trial, patient usually receive the highest dose of treatment that did not cause harmful side effect in the phase 1 part of the clinical trial. Combining phases 1 and 2 may allow research questions to be answered for more quickly or with fewer patients. Now let's come the building factories now. Building factories, normally it will take 4 years. It will start it 2028 and it will end 2032. But in pandemic case, the building factories, it will have to start with phase 1 trial. As because for accelerating the vaccine development. Now let's come in manufacturing phases. In case of manufacturing stages, it is essential to speed up production in pandemic situation in such a way that huge quantity of vaccine could be distributed in market to eradicate this COVID-19 disease from the world. Now let's come in approval. This stage is very vital, which I have already discussed about in my previous slide. During a pandemic, a vaccine may receive emergency use authorization before getting formal approval. And after approval, a vaccine may receive emergency use authorization before getting formal approval. And after approval, distribution should be very fast in such a way that common people get this vaccine very early to immune themselves. Now let's come some disadvantage of vaccine development in pandemic situation. Accelerating vaccine development could some disadvantage, and it could result in less time spent on evaluating the safety of the vaccine. Some patient could experience serious adverse effect. What is the adverse effect? Shortening the timeline could also mean that scientists learn less about the potential range of adverse effect. Moving quickly to authorize and distribute tests may increase risks associated with their accuracy. As a result, there is a potential that some tests could show patients have not been exposed to or infected by the virus that causes COVID-19 when they actually have been. In addition, while tests may be developed quickly, their widespread use could be limited by the availability of the supplies required to conduct testing safely, including swabs and personal protective equipment. So at last, we have concluded that finding the right balance between the speed and safety and accuracy and effectiveness is challenging. It requires careful assessment and may need to be adjusted over time. Now let's come various type of vaccine. First one is virus vaccine. Virus vaccine are of two types, weakened virus and inactivated virus. What is weakened virus? A virus is conventionally weakened for a vaccine by being passed through animal or human cells until it pick up mutation that make it less able to cause disease. For example, Codagenix in Farmingdale, New York is working with the Serum Institute of India, a vaccine manufacturer in Pune, to weaken SARS-CoV-2 by altering its genetic code so that viral protein are produced less efficiently. Now let's come inactivated virus. In this vaccine, the virus is rendered uninfectious using chemicals such as formaldehyde or heat, making them, however, require starting with large quantities of infectious virus. This diagram shows the mechanism of the weakened virus and inactivated virus. I have given three examples of inactivated virus. Recently, I have heard about Covaxin, the first indigenous vaccine by Bharat Biotech in India. And second one is inactivated vaccine by Sinovac Biotech in China and inactivated vaccine by Sinopharm in China. Now let's come second one, viral vector vaccine. What is viral vector vaccine? Viral vector vaccine use live virus to carry DNA into human cells. The DNA contained in the virus encode antigen that once expressed in the infected human cells elicit an immune response. Now let's come viral vector vaccine are of two types. One is replicating viral vector, two non-replicating viral vector. In case of replicating viral vector, the viral genes can replicate within the cells itself. This is a coronavirus spike gene and this is the viral gene. And in case of non-replicating viral vector such as adenovirus, in this case the viral genes are some inactive, so it cannot replicate within the cells. This is a coronavirus spike gene. No licensed vaccine use this method, but they have a long history in gene therapy. Booster shot can be needed to induce long-lasting immunity. US-based drug giant Johnson & Johnson is working on this approach. Another example is AZ-122. These vaccines are developed by University of Oxford and AstraZeneca, where adenovirus used as a viral vector, which contain genetic code of the protein spike found on the coronavirus and triggered a strong immune response in the human body. The vaccine is in combined phase trial in South Africa and Brazil. Now let's come third one, nucleic acid vaccine. Nucleic acid vaccine are of two types, DNA vaccine and RNA vaccine. What is DNA vaccine? DNA vaccine contain and encode the viral genes, which is essential for infection. Here, the DNA encode the coronavirus spike gene. A process called electroporation create pores in membrane to increase uptake DNA into the cell. When DNA enter into the cell, it can release the viral protein. And this protein can elicit the immune response. And another one is RNA vaccine. RNA is often encapsulated in a lipid coat, so it can enter the cell. RNA and DNA based vaccine are safe and easy to develop. To produce them involves making genetic material only, not the virus, but they are unproven. No licensed vaccine use this technology. Here, for example, mRNA-1273. This vaccine are developed by American biotechnological company Moderna. An mRNA vaccine, Biotech Fosun Pharma, Pfizer, and another RNA vaccine, Imperial College of London, and DNA vaccine developed by Zydus Cadila. Now let's come last protein-based vaccine. What is protein-based vaccine? Protein-based vaccine, 28 teams are working on vaccine with viral protein subunit. Most are focusing on the virus spike protein or a key part of it called the receptor binding domain. Similar vaccine against the SARS virus protected monkey against infection but have not been tested in people. To work, this vaccine might require adjuvant immune stimulating molecule delivered alongside the vaccine as well as multiple dose. There is a mechanism of protein based vaccine. Here is a spike protein of the coronavirus and a virus-like particle. Empty virus cell mimic the coronavirus structure but are not infectious because they lack genetic material. Five team are working on virus-like particle VLP vaccine, which can trigger a strong immune response but can be difficult to manufacture. This is a diagram of the mechanism of virus-like particles. There are two examples, Novavax USA and Vaccine Australia. Both are using the protein-based vaccine. Now let's come mRNA-1273. This vaccine are developed by Moderna, an American biotech company, and collaboration with NIH, National Institute of Health. mRNA-1273 is a novel lipid nanoparticle LNP encapsulated mRNA based vaccine that encodes for a full-length perfusion stabilized spike protein of SARS-CoV-2. Why novel lipid nanoparticle? As because mRNA are lysed by extracellular RNAs. So mRNA-1273 is coated by novel lipid nanoparticle. It can easily enter the cells and release the mRNA of coronavirus spike protein. mRNA-1273 vaccine was provided as a sterile liquid for injection at a concentration of 0.5 mg per milliliter Normal saline was used as a diluent to prepare the dose administered. Now, I am telling about some advantage of mRNA vaccine. This mRNA vaccine uses genetic sequence of spike protein, not by working on the virus itself. So, this platform provides advantage in speed and efficiency across basic science, manufacturing, and clinical development. This diagram shows the concept to phase 1 in 42 days in case of Moderna company for vaccine development.